All right, here's a question where you are asked to solve this triangle. In other words, you need to figure out all sides and all angles. Now, first they give us angle M, 43 degrees, 22 minutes. I would convert that into a decimal degree. So I would go 42 degrees and then go 22 divided by 60. And then what we get from that, and add that to the 42. So it'd be 42.37 degrees. So that's what angle M is. 42.37 degrees. Angle N is the 90 degree. And then to get P, all angles of a triangle have to add up to 180. So if I add these two and then subtract from 180, I'll get that. And so I think that'll be 47.63 degrees. Okay, so there's all my angles. Sides. I have this side over here, so that'll be side M. So side M is 23.2, and I don't have the other sides. Okay, so what I need to do is figure out what those other sides are. So to do that, I can use Pythagoras, or I can use sine, theta, opposite of hypotenuse, cos theta, adjacent of hypotenuse, or tan theta, opposite of adjacent. And all I need to know is I need to know two of the three variables in any one of those equations. So, if this is the angle that I know, and I start with it, I know the P as well, but this is one given. So this is going to be my angle. So this side over here is the opposite side. This is the hypotenuse, and this is the adjacent side. So, if I want to say know what the hypotenuse is, I need to use the opposite side and a hypotenuse. So over here, that's this one. So let's use sine theta. So sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. So sine of the angle, 42.37, is equal to the opposite side, 23.2, over the hypotenuse, which I don't know, but it's side N. So we'll call it an N. Now to solve for N, it's in a bad spot because it's in the denominator. So to get it in the numerator, I can multiply both sides by n. And here these n's cancel out. So I'll be left with n times the sine of 42.37 is equal to 23.2. But I just want to solve for n. I don't want that sine thing. So I'm going to divide this side by the sine of 42.37. So those will cancel. But if I divide that side, I also have to divide this side, sine of 42.37. So on my calculator, I do that. Hopefully this will work. Oops. Okay. So what was I doing? 23.2 divided by the sine of 42.37. Okay, and that gives me, I made a mistake. I'm in radians, I should be in degrees. Yeah, 34.4. So N is 34.4. And that is longer than the other side, and the hypotenuse should be on the other side. So that makes sense. Now, got five things, and now I need to know what this side is. And P side, that's this one down here, is my adjacent side. So I need to use one of these ratios up here that has an adjacent in it. And like I could use a cosine, because that's got an adjacent, because I know my hypotenuse now. Or I could use this one, because I know the opposite, and I'm looking for the adjacent. So either one. Why don't we, just to change it up, let's use cosine. So, cosine of an angle is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. So the cosine of 42.37 is equal to the adjacent side, I don't know that one, but it's called P, over the hypotenuse, which we just found out, 34.4. This time notice that the variable is on the top. And so if it's on the top, that's a good spot for it. So to get it by itself, I have to get rid of the 34.4, so I multiply both sides by 34.4. So these cancel. On the calculator, I'll just type that up. So 34.4 cos times cos of 42.37 comes out to 25.4. Smaller than the hypotenuse, so that makes it to 25.4. Now, one thing that you could have done, if I didn't know that angle there, I could have used Pythagoras. Pythagoras is c squared equals a squared plus b squared, where c is the hypotenuse. So if I just figured that out, I could put that there, 34.4 squared is equal to, and then the other side don't matter. Let's use the 23.2 that I know already, squared plus b squared. So to solve that, 34.4 squared, let me figure out what that is, 34.4 squared, that's, I didn't put a point in there, 0.4 squared, 1183, 0.36 equals 23.2 squared. Plus b squared. I want to solve for b squared, so I'll subtract these two. Whoops, 36 minus 5, 38.24 equals b squared, so subtract. 1183.36 subtract. 538.24. Okay, so that's 645.12 equals b squared, and then square root both sides. So it'll be b is equal to whatever the square root of 645.12 is. And I'm hoping that it comes out to that. Okay, so 645.12 square root 645.12 25.4. Oh, and that's what I got up. Okay, hopefully that helps you solve that triangle, and I showed you a couple of different ways of solving the basic trig equations, and then also a couple of different ways of solving flat lines. Using either a trig ratio or using pi.